I would be thinking about you right now. Another thing that I noticed as I've gotten older too is carbs. I know a lot of people talk about carbohydrates. I know some people try to make healthy decisions when it comes to their food choices, and they think that they need to eliminate carbohydrates altogether out of their diets. Can you explain the role carbohydrates can play in the body and how the right carbs can help you actually get in shape?
Yeah, definitely. So carbs, another thing that has become the enemy in like the sort of lay public understanding, a lot of people think carbs are the enemy. And from my perspective, I think this is for a few reasons. I think that people generally think carbs are bad because they know people who do well with like the keto diet. Mm-hmm. And the keto diet, super popular right now. You might have a friend or two or three or more who've gone on the keto diet and they've lost weight. And then people automatically attribute that to carbohydrates and taking out carbohydrates from their diet. I would say that the keto diet is the most popular diet right now. That hasn't been true in the past. It hasn't always been the most popular diet, but there have been different kinds of diets like that. And so I think that there's this mentality. Also, because something you mentioned before, Kendall, things like white bread is bad, or like maybe the foods that we think of when we think of carbohydrates lead us to believing that they're one of the worst choices that we can make. But I would contend that you have some of the foods that we would even think of as being the healthiest within that carbohydrate category as well. For example, fruits and vegetables and whole grains, some of the staples that I mentioned having in your diet just to create that base are primarily carbohydrates. I would say it's more important which ones you choose when you choose your carbohydrates than it is just eliminating carbohydrates altogether. I would say you'd be in a lot of trouble if you totally eliminated all whole grains, all fruits, all vegetables from your diet. And so I think that there's even this misnomer. You might hear somebody saying, yeah, I took out all carbohydrates. Mm-hmm. Well, what do they really mean when they say that? I love it when people tell me, yeah, I've eliminated all carbohydrates. I ate all fruits and vegetables the other day. I'm like, well,
you still eat some carbs.
Eliminate carbohydrates if you're consuming yourself. And I mean, it sounds like carbs are your base if you're eating primarily fruits and vegetables, right?
Right.
And so the choice in carbs that you make is really important. But carbs, it's true, can make you retain water. So if I for the next week didn't eat any carbs or didn't eat many carbs, my body's gonna lose weight just because of water, for one. So if I stop taking in carbs that retain water over the course of the next week, it wouldn't be uncommon for somebody to lose 5 pounds or maybe more, depending on how much water your bodies are training. But I'd say that retaining water is not actually a bad thing and is actually a good thing, especially in the summer months, to keep us from becoming dehydrated. It's a natural thing for your body to retain some water. But if you consume too many carbs, same is true with salt. If you take in too much salt, mm-hmm. your body is going to hang on to that. So if you have a heavy carb dinner the next day, you might feel kind of bloated. Your body is holding on to some of that water. So carbs aren't the enemy. I wouldn't say eliminate them. I would say you just want to include the right ones in, especially fruits, vegetables, and whole grains, the things that you've probably been taught since you were young. I would say none of that has changed. Things in nutritional sciences change, but those things haven't. Those things have been really consistent.
Yeah, because I know me personally, I know some other people, that's why they say, oh, I eliminated carbs. When you think of carbs, you just think of something like a pasta, you think of like a candy, like you just think of those type of carbohydrates. But as you mentioned, carbohydrates are in these fruits and vegetables and whole grains that we eat every day. Not too many people look at those foods mm-hmm. as a source of carbohydrates. And I know another thing that you touched on that stuck out to me and that I keep in my head when I always mm-hmm. think about my eating process is the ratio that you should have carbs to protein, especially when you're trying to get in shape, is 3-1. 3 is the ratio 3-1 with 3 carbohydrates and 1 type of protein in terms of your eating habits. And that was like very integral into how I eat nowadays, because I'll incorporate more carbs than I do protein. And that's another common misperception that I want to touch on as well with you. People say, oh, I'm trying to gain weight, so I'm going to eat as much protein as I can. But people don't understand that proper balance of carbohydrates and protein. Talk to us about how protein consumption is supposed to go when one is trying to gain weight, and how people should strive for a balance between proteins and carbohydrates.
Yeah, great question. Very common misconception. So I worked as a personal trainer for 3 years, and a lot of the guys I worked with were like, I'm going to pound the protein because I'm trying to gain muscle. So this misconception is even common among people in the field who don't have as much of a nutrition background. So protein is important. The 3-to-1 ratio that you mentioned, Kendall, is really important after exercise especially. So people think about having protein after exercise to help their muscles recover and repair. This is true, and protein is absolutely necessary in that process. But what they don't realize is that carbohydrates are even more necessary after, as far as like the total amount that you get. So that 3-to-1, 3 parts carbohydrate to 1 part protein, and carbohydrates help the protein actually do their work within the body. And another thing that can happen is, if you don't have the right carbohydrates in place, you can throw off your hormones. So cortisol levels. So cortisol is known as the stress hormone. If I go and work out, we generally think of this as a good stress on the body, but we would expect cortisol levels to increase. Cortisol, the stress hormone, can break down all kinds of different things within your body. Muscle is one of those things. And if I don't get carbohydrates in my body, and I just put in protein, my body doesn't have the carbohydrates to combat that cortisol that builds up. So I have the stress hormone building up within my body, and the protein doesn't really help reduce that in the same way. So actually, I think in my mind, it's like, I think putting protein into my body is so important after exercise. But really what I've done is I've increased cortisol, and this is breaking down muscle a lot of times at a faster rate than the protein can even help the muscle repair. And so I might be doing the opposite of what I think I'm doing, and it might be counterproductive to just put in protein and not carbohydrates. Cortisol is not the only hormone that is involved in this process, but it's a good example of what happens. And so to regulate your hormones that help with muscle building, you need carbohydrates. And also just to allow protein to do its work, you need carbohydrates to kind of fuel it within that process. And so carbs and protein are both super important. I tend to focus more on carbohydrates just because of the misnomers that we have in our culture. I feel like right now in this day and age, I don't need to tell anybody that protein is important because we already overemphasize it. Right. And we de-emphasize the importance of carbohydrates. So in general, I tend to advocate more for carbohydrates in my classes, just to combat sort of like that cultural perception that we have. And I try to get people to back off a little bit on protein, but I'd say they're both super important. But just based on where we're at, I kind of advocate more for one than the other.
Yeah, because carbohydrates serve as a source of energy, where protein serves as that building blocks to rebuild your muscles, which is integral after a workout, because after you have damaged your muscles by working out, you need the protein to help repair and rebuild those muscles. But carbohydrates come in to give you that energy boost after a workout, before, during a workout, if you're drinking like a Gatorade, for example, to give you the energy to keep going in those workouts. And I think a lot of people don't really touching that or notice that. They just think, like I said, oh, protein this, let me eat all these protein bars, let me get this protein shake, let me get protein. That's all you really hear.